So it's May, and we have a lot of celebrations between me and my wife in May. Her birthday's in May, Mother's Day's in May, our anniversary's in May. And what she said she really wanted was she wanted a really nice coffee maker. And I said, okay, sounds good. And she was showing me some ideas of them, like Bed Vistas, or whatever the hell they are. And they're like $300 for a really nice coffee maker. And it's like, okay, that's a bit steep. And the more I was looking at it, the more I was doing a little research on it, just trying to get a decent one, trying to make sure we got the right one. And I realized that you can actually, for $300, you just want a coffee maker, you can get a commercial grade Bunn coffee maker in the same price range, which makes a whole lot of coffee and honestly just makes sense. And you can make a little bit of coffee or a whole lot of coffee with it. Both are pretty cool. So I grabbed it. I grabbed the stainless steel stuff for it because she wanted this thing to be all stainless steel, which the Bunn is. And some of those other, super fancy ones are all stainless steel, no plastics touching anything. So I bought it correctly for that. And the stainless steel funnel comes with this extra little tip, which restricts the flow a little bit coming out of the funnel. I don't know if you can see that. But it's just a little quarter 28 screw with a big hole through the center of it and a little retaining nut. So this is all right if you're making like 6 cups of coffee. But if you're only making one or two, like normally in the morning for, it's still a little too big the hole. So I figured, let me grab a vented screw off McMaster or something, and we'll put that in its place. Because that's a much smaller hole, and that should help a lot. And then I could tune this hole from there to get the taste right for it. But this is quarter 28, the stock Bunn one. All they have is a quarter 20 vented. So now I gotta make this retainer real quick. So let me do this and let me show you guys it in the machine, I guess, and then we'll go from there. Faster speed. So this oil I'm using in this cup, actually, this is coconut oil. Like, it's not food grade, but it's better than a petroleum product. It's more for those massage parlors that you guys see. But you can get it in big vats for fairly cheap, and it cuts pretty well with stainless. That's perfect. I don't need to cut that. I gotta turn it down a touch. Clean it up. how much can we knurl? Right. Pretty good. Must be a little deeper though. Some bite on that with my finger, so that should be good narrow wise. Like that, really tiny. Not the straight narrows the bun has, but that's fine. All right. I don't know why center drills go away, but they do. One thing I learned you gotta watch, especially with the stainless steel vented, like I tried to save time by just buying a stainless steel one of these that's vented already, but they don't drill the holes perfectly accurate, so it's a little skewed. Not that it matters, but I picked the straightest one. Try to get that out of the way. Fast, but oh well, it worked. All right, we're gonna size the hole for the thread. 0.193 or number 10 bit. Gotta do is I gotta bring the chamfer back in and chamfer it out all the way to the leading edge. Try a little bit bigger piece of stock to start, would have been a little nicer. try to clean this up a touch. Looks pretty good. Let's see. Might have to go deeper. That's a shame. Let me go a little deeper. You mean such a pain? I don't know what's being such a bastard. Let's Let's get the hand tap. It's just this particular screw. There we go. All right. Now, I need to machine this down to be like that. Which is going to be difficult if I drop it. I'm just going to bring this down best we can. We don't have to be perfect. I think I'd still get a Torx in there, maybe. That'd be nice. Find that. Alright, I found it. I cleaned it up a little bit. That's pretty much all she wrote on this one. Need to... All right. Let's see. Need to undo it now. All right. Got it. So, let me come close to the camera. Come on. Focus. Really struggling to focus. All right. So that's the new one. Little hole. That's the new collar. And this is the original bun. Much bigger hole. All right, let me show you how it does in the coffee machine. I'm sorry this is gonna be shaky, but let's do this. This is the stainless filter, or the stainless filter housing. That's quite the large hole in the center of it. And you can adjust the strength of the coffee or how long the water sits in the coffee grounds by adjusting the nozzle. So this was the stock nozzle, or the nozzle tip that they told you to put in it. Put this down. Sorry it's so dark, but it's nighttime. I'm just gonna pour some water in and just cycle some water through. It's not on, but it'll still displace itself.
At least the stock flow rate. It's a little slow when there's coffee in it. But not that much. These keep flowing until it seeks its own level again. That's about it. Just gonna pop out this one. I put in the new one. Sorry, I lost you guys there for a second. Slipped in the new one. There it goes. And that is dramatically slower. So the coffee, or the water, is going to sit in the coffee for a very long time. We might have to tune this and open this up a little bit, but that's pretty simple. Just run a little bit bigger drill bit through until we get the flavor setup that we want. But yeah, that's it for this one. See you guys.